Let's now go to Aurora Province, where storm surges have been reported. Let's get an update from our correspondent, Shara Zambrano. So, Shara, good morning. Give us an update on the situation there in Aurora.
Yes, it's been raining here for a good 11 hours straight. We do recall that the rains came at around 8 p.m. last night, and it hasn't let up since. It only got worse by the hour, and we saw the full force of Typhoon Ulysses at around 3 a.m. Now, before that, a couple of hours before that, we tried to make our way around the streets of Dingalan, Aurora, where we spent the night, and we arrived at a port area here in Dingalan because we wanted to feel the height and the power of the waves that they say would come with the coming of Typhoon Ulysses. And we were pretty far from the water. We were actually closer to the street than the ocean, and we were filming from afar. And little did we know, just in a matter of seconds, that same wave that we were seeing from afar would already be at our feet and even go past us onto the street level. So it was kind of our rude awakening as to how a storm surge works and how it's deceivingly slow but very, very powerful in reality. Whenever this storm surge would press on towards the pier, towards the street, we could hear the cracking of wooden boats just from the sheer force of these waves that keep coming. And so we had to retreat several meters back. And we did see that at some point it was regularly, consistently already reaching the street level. And so we pulled back a little bit more. And we took footage of just the large pieces of debris that were surrounding and quickly multiplying all around the town of Dingalan. And before we knew it, we could no longer reach the pier, the port area, the seaside anymore, because it was no longer passable because of this debris. Now, this brings us to the problem of Dingalan right now, because we were actually with the rescuers of Dingalan when we were going around the town last night. And that means they were stuck with us. They could no longer rescue anyone who was making a distress call that night. And all the way to this moment. Actually, they're huddled in a meeting right now with the town mayor of Dingalan to figure out their next steps. How do they clear these large pieces of debris? How do they get to the seaside communities, the coastal communities that are clearly in need of attention and help at the moment? So we're about to head into that meeting right now just to see how they figure this out. Because you just see how important it is to conduct preemptive evacuations and forced evacuations before the weather disturbance actually comes. Because no matter how much they wanted to reach these coastal towns last night, they tried as best as they could to find every available route, but it was no longer possible. And they did manage to evacuate more than 5,000 residents here in Dingalan alone, and that's a win. That's a good sign. Now, all that's left for them to do is check on those communities again and see if maybe some people didn't evacuate, and just how they can reach them and how they can help them now.
Okay, Shara, number one, how high was the storm surge that you saw? And number two, you mentioned that the rescue team is still trying to reach the coastal areas for possible residents who might have decided not to evacuate early on, right? But would you know how many residents issued distress calls based on the monitoring of the rescue teams? How many people are still they're still looking for?
Well, I can't give you a direct or an exact number of how many distress calls were made last night, because there were several teams of the MDRMO that should have been or would have been deployed last night had the roads been passable. But with the team that we were with, just in the short time that we tried to drive around, they received two distress calls from different coastal areas, and they could reach neither of these residents who were asking for help. I did ask them for an estimate as to how big the waves, the storm surge we were actually watching in front of us was. And they said, you know, on paper, they said it would reach 1 to 2 meters. But from what we're seeing now, it's clearly a lot more than that. And they were pegging it at 3 meters, actually. Mm,
okay. Now, any reported casualties so far, either dead or injured? And is there electricity in the town or perhaps in other parts of the province still?
There is no longer any electricity, as the municipal hall just fired their genset last night just to create some kind of reference point for the town in the darkness and to make sure that the people who were there, who were working during the typhoon, could still function in a basic capacity. We had, as of last night, province-wide in Aurora, there hasn't been or hadn't been any casualties reported yet. But as we all know, it's always the morning after where we'll see a clearer picture in terms of casualties.
Okay, Shara Zambrano, thank you very much for that update. Stay safe there.